A very good morning, student. Today let me start the physics class. New lesson, unit number 5. The topic is electromagnetic waves. The topic is electromagnetic waves. Learning objectives are: in this unit, the student is exposed to them. What are the topic discussed about this electromagnetic waves? Means first point, the displacement current. This is a important 2 mark and a 3 mark question. Then the Maxwell's corrections to Ampere's circuit law. This is 5 mark question. Then third point, Maxwell equation in integral form. This is the 3 mark question. Production and properties of electromagnetic waves. Its experiment. This is a detailed question answer. The next one, sources of electromagnetic waves. Then last one is electromagnetic spectrum. This is very important topic from your 5th lesson. Very important detailed question also. Then objectives and the 2 mark question. The next, introduction. We see the world around as through light. Light from the sun is one of the source of energy without which human beings cannot survive in this planet. Light plays crucial role in understanding the structure and the properties of various things from atom to universe. Without light, even our eye cannot see objects. What is light? What is mean by light? Light is a form of energy. Light is a form of energy. This puzzle made many physicists sleepless until middle of 19th century. Earlier, many scientists thought that optics and electromagnetism are two different branches of physics. But from the work of James Clerk Maxwell, who actually enlightened and concept of light from his theoretical prediction that light is an electromagnetic wave which moves with the speed equal to 3×10⁸ meter per second in free space or vacuum. Later it was confirmed that visible light is just only small portion of electromagnetic spectrum, which ranges from gamma rays to radio waves. Gamma rays to radio waves. In unit 4, we studied that time-varying magnetic field produces an electric field. This is very important concept from the 4th lesson. Magnetic field produces an electric field. Faraday's law, electromagnetic induction. Maxwell strongly believed that nature must possess symmetry, and he asked the following question: when the time varying magnetic field produces an electric field, why not the time varying electric field produces a magnetic field? Later he proved that it is indeed true. In 1888, H. Henry experimentally verified Maxwell's prediction, and hence this understanding result in new technological invention, especially in wireless communication, laser, light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation, technology, radar means radio detection and ranging, etc. So by this diagram we can easily understand this topic. Then in today's digital world, cell phones, we have greater influence in our day-to-day life. It is faster and more effective mode of transferring information from one place to another. It works on the basis that light is an electromagnetic wave. In hospitals, The location of bone fracture can be detected using X-rays, which is also an electromagnetic waves. For cooking, microwave oven is used. The application, so the microwave is also an electromagnetic wave. There are plenty of applications of electromagnetic waves in engineering, medicine, example laser surgery, etc. Defense, example radar signals, and also in fundamental scientific research. In this unit, basic of electromagnetic waves are discussed. So first 3 mark and 2 mark question topic is displacement current and Maxwell's correction to Ampere's circuital law. Ampere's circuital law, displacement current and Maxwell correction to Ampere's circuital law. Induced magnetic field. Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction states that the change in magnetic field produces an electric field. Mathematically, Faraday's, what is the concept of Faraday's law? Change in magnetic field which produces an electric field. So mathematically we can written as line integral of E vector dot dl vector is equal to minus of d by dt into phi b is equal to minus of d by dt into line integral of, that means surface integral, b vector dot da vector. Line integral of E vector dot dl vector is nothing but electric field induced along a closed loop. This term is nothing but variation of magnetic flux with the time. The next term is changing magnetic field, magnetic flux phi b in the region enclosed by the loop, where phi b is the magnetic flux and d by dt is the total derivative with respect to time. Equation 5.1 means that the electric field E vector is induced along the closed loop by the change in magnetic flux phi b in the region of encircled by the loop. From the symmetry consideration, James Clerk Maxwell showed that the change in electric field also produces a magnetic field, which is given by, so this is very important concept, change in electric field also produces a magnetic field. But in Faraday's law, change in magnetic field produces an electric field. Here Maxwell's statement is change in electric field also produces a magnetic field, which is given by line integral of B vector dot dl vector is equal to minus of d by dt into phi e is equal to minus of d by dt into surface integral E vector dot da vector. This term is nothing but magnetic field induced along a closed loop. This term is nothing but variation of electric flux with the time. This term indicated the change in electric flux phi b in the region enclosed by the loop, where phi e means electric flux, where phi e is the electric flux. This is known as Maxwell's law of induction, which explains that the magnetic field B vector is induced along the circular loop by the change in electric flux phi e in the region encircled by that loop. This symmetry between electric and magnetic field explains the existence of electromagnetic waves such as radio waves, gamma rays, infrared rays, example. This point is very important point. Electromagnetic wave such as radio wave, gamma rays, infrared rays are all rays of electromagnetic waves. The next topic is displacement current Maxwell correction. Displacement current Maxwell correction. In order to understand how the changing electric field induces magnetic field, how the changing electric field induces magnetic field, let us consider a situation of charging of a parallel plate capacitor. This is a parallel plate capacitor. Charging of parallel plate capacitor which contains non-conducting, here the parallel plate conductor or non-contact with each other. So non-conducting medium between the plates. Let the time depend current IC, that means IC means conducting current, called conducting, sorry, conduction current. IC means called conduction current be passed through the wire to charge the capacitor. First, we should charge the capacitor, parallel plate capacitor. According to the Ampere circuit law, can be used in to find the magnetic field produced around the current carrying wire. To calculate the magnetic field at a point P, here point P near the wire and outside the capacitor, let us draw a circular Amperean loop. This is a circular Amperean loop which enclosed the circular surface S1. Using the Ampere circuit law for this loop, we get line integral, enclosing integral B vector dot dl vector is equal to mu naught into conduction current IC. This formula is very very important formula for your 2-mark problem and objectives problem. From this diagram we can easily understand this concept. Now the same loop is enclosed by the balloon shaped loop, balloon shaped surface S2, such that boundary of two surfaces S1 and S2 are same, but the shape of the surface is different. This is circular shape, this is a hemisphere shape, that means balloon shape. As Ampere law applied for a given enclosed loop, that means given closed loop, does not depend on the shape of the enclosing surface. The integrals should give the same answer. But by applying Ampere circuit law for the surface S2, this surface S2, we get line integral of S2, B vector dot dl vector is equal to 0. Because the right hand side of the, this right hand side of the equation is 0 here. 0, because the surface S2 nowhere touches the wire carrying conduction current, and further there is no current flowing between the plates of the capacitor, gap between the plates. So the magnetic field at a point P is 0. So magnetic field at a point P also 0. Hence there is an inconsistency between equation 5.3 and 5.4 here. This is the equation 5.3. This is the equation 5.4. Inconsistency between equation 5.4 and 5.3. Maxwell resolved this inconsistency as follows. While the capacitor is being charged up, so capacitor should be charged, varying electric field is produced between the capacitor plate. Here, varying the electric field between the capacitor plates, there must be a current associated with the changing electric field between the capacitor plates. In other words, time varying electric field or time varying electric flux produces a current. This is known as displacement current flowing between the plates of the capacitor. So note down this paragraph. For Gauss's law of electrostatic, the electric flux between the plates of the capacitor is line as a phi e is equal to line integral of e vector dot dA vector is equal to ea. Already we know this formula from the first lesson, Gauss law, ea is equal to q by epsilon naught, where a is the area of the plates of the capacitor. The change in electric flux is given by d phi e divided by dt is equal to 1 by epsilon naught into dq, can be written as dq divided by dt. Then dq divided by dt is equal to, here in this equation we get epsilon naught into d phi e divided by dt. Here dq divided by dt is nothing but current, because current is nothing but rate of change of charge, rate of change of flow of charge with respect to time taken. So here rate of change of charge id means, this is the displacement current. Displacement current is equal to epsilon naught d phi e divided by dt. Then where dq divided by dt is equal to id, is known as displacement current or Maxwell's displacement current. This formula is very very important. This is the definition of displacement current. Please note it down, children. This is 2-mark question. Listen carefully. The displacement current can be defined as the current which comes into play in the region in which the electric field or the electric flux is changing with the time. Once again, repeat. The current which comes into play in the region in which the electric field or the electric flux is changing with time. In other words, whenever the change in electric field takes place, displacement current is produced. Whenever the change in electric field takes place, displacement current is produced. Maxwell modified Ampere's law as line integral of B vector dot dl vector is equal to mu naught I. Here I is nothing but IC plus ID. That means conduction current plus displacement current. Mu naught into conduction current plus displacement current. Line integral of B vector dot dl vector is equal to mu naught. Multiply these two terms, we get mu naught IC plus mu naught epsilon naught, because ID value is epsilon naught into epsilon naught into d phi by dt. Substituting this value, we get ID is nothing but epsilon naught d phi e divided by dt. Mu naught into epsilon naught d phi e divided by dt, where the total current enclosed by the surface becomes the sum of conduction current and the displacement current. Therefore, I is equal to IC plus ID. This equation is known as Ampere's Maxwell law. So, please note it down. This is very very important equation. Ampere's Maxwell law. When the current in the circuit is constant, the displacement current is zero. This point is also very important for your aptitude type. When the current in the circuit is constant, the displacement current is zero. Then between the plate, the conduction current is zero, the displacement current is not zero. Displacement current is not zero. One second repeat. Between the plates, the conduction current is zero. Please note it down. While the displacement current is non-zero, this point also very important. This displacement current or time varying electric field can also produce a magnetic field between the plates of the capacitor. Magnetic field between the plates of the capacitor. The magnetic field at a point P, at a point inside the capacitor, is perpendicular to the electric field as shown in this figure. This magnetic field can be determined using equation 5.6. The next important importance of Maxwell correction. What is the importance of Maxwell correction? Earth receive radiation from sun and the other stars. These radiation travel through empty space where there are no electric charges and hence no electric current. Ampere's law says that only electric current can produce a magnetic field. Only electric current can produce the magnetic field from the Ampere's law. If Ampere's law alone is true, there will not be any radiation. Maxwell correction term mu naught epsilon naught d phi e divided by dt in Ampere's law ensures that time varying electric field or displacement current can also produce a magnetic field. This is an important point of the Maxwell correction. Electric field or displacement current varying, time varying electric field or displacement current can also produce the magnetic field. Though conduction current is zero in an empty space, displacement current does exist. So the equation 5.6 becomes line integral of B vector dot dl vector is equal to mu naught epsilon naught d phi e divided by dt. In stars, due to the thermal excitation of atoms, time varying electric field is produced, which in turn produces time varying magnetic field. According to Faraday's law, the time varying magnetic field produces again time varying electric field and so on. The coupled time varying electric and magnetic field travel through an empty space with the speed of light and is called electromagnetic wave. So please note it down, children. The coupled time-varying electric and magnetic field travel through an empty space with the speed of light and is called electromagnetic wave. This is the definition of electromagnetic wave. Even though Maxwell initially started with purely symmetry argument, his correction term explained one of the important aspects of the universe, namely the existence of electromagnetic waves. Thank you.